NASCAR's committed to not increasing horsepower, plus charter negotiations, they don't sound like they're going very well. All right, everybody, welcome back to the Break Hard channel. My name is Matt. We have a lot of things to talk about today. Well, two main topics to talk about today. The first being that NASCAR's committed to not increasing horsepower in order to fix the short track program. So this past weekend at Texas, they met with drivers and they told drivers we're committed to making the short track package better. And we love commitment. We love commitment like a meathead loves GNC. So really happy to hear that. However, bad news, if you like horsepower, NASCAR said they're committed to not increasing horsepower, but they're going to try to fix this through the tires. So on one hand, we love the commitment. On the other hand, I don't love the commitment that they're not increasing horsepower because they are staunch in making sure that they will not do that. The same way that Jontay Porter was very committed to ruining his NBA career by betting on the game. Don't do that. Pete Rose taught us all that lesson. Which does make me wonder sometimes, what happens if somebody bet on a NASCAR race, driver-wise? It'd be so hard to manufacture a race. Not necessarily, but imagine like Rasha saying bets on the race and goes out there and drives through a bunch of people to make sure that they can't win just so his random bet maybe, possibly, could win. It'd be really difficult. Never mind. Back to the original topic at hand here, and that is fixing the short track package. So NASCAR is committed to doing this through the tires with Goodyear. Their idea is to create something like what we saw at Bristol, but maybe not to the full extreme because they don't want to listen to Freddie Kraft whine about how dangerous it is to have cars going different speeds on track. So they'd like to have it somewhere in the middle, not being what we have now, not the extreme where tires are gone after 40 laps, which is literally like 20 miles at Bristol. Find a happy medium in there. And they're looking to try to do that. And I think that's a good thing, right? If you're not going to increase horsepower, and we all know they don't want to increase horsepower because right now they're trying to convince Honda to join the series. And Honda doesn't want to join NASCAR if NASCAR is going to be running 1,000 horsepower, 900 horsepower. They're looking at that 670 range right now and possibly a different engine formula going forward. But that's, again, another topic. Did a video on that. We'll talk about that if the time ever comes. So for right now, NASCAR doesn't want to increase horsepower. Okay, fine. They want to do tires. Denny Hamlin talked about this on his podcast, Actions Detrimental. And whether you like Denny or not on the racetrack, Denny, the car owner on his podcast, when he breaks down things about the sport, is actually very good. And I encourage you all to go listen to that because he talked about the tires. And he said, honestly, the main difference between the Gen 6 car and the Gen 7 car is the amount of load that the car has. He said with the Gen 6 car, the load on the left side tires wore those tires out more than what they do on the Gen 7 car. That's why we saw Joey Logano run 180 of the 400 laps at Martinsville a couple weeks ago on the same left side tires. You should not be able to run half the race on the same tires. I understand it's only 100 miles, but it's not good for the racing is essentially what it comes down to here. So they're going to look at tires, and they're committed to not doing anything else with aero. All the aero change has gone out the window. They're not focused on aero anymore, which is good because they haven't worked up to this point. And some people, both Chad Knaus, Denny Hamlin, and others, believe that taking the downforce off the car has hurt the tire wear, which does make sense in theory, but you had to try to battle one extreme with the other here. And NASCAR went the aero route rather than the tire route at first. Probably should have gone the tire route. Whatever, hindsight 2020. You'd love the Monday morning quarterback, backseat driver, this, however many other references I can try to make to that. So they're going to go with the tire situation. Joey Logano on his SiriusXM show on Tuesday mentioned that NASCAR really can't go to a narrower tire because that would be a huge cost to the team. It's cost prohibitive. Like, it does not make any sense. And he's right, because going to a narrow tire means all new different rims, all new different tires. Like, you have to go out and make different tires at this point, which is something we'll get to a second because they're going to have to anyways. But also, these cars are built to hold that tire, which means you have to put a spacer on the hub and everything about it. Like, that whole thing. The whole rear end and the front end of these race cars would have to be redesigned, essentially. And that's just not going to happen, at least not right now. So his idea was to go to groove tires, kind of like what we've seen in Formula One. And we've talked about this before on here, on this channel as well. They can do that. The idea is having less of a contact patch. I'd love to see it happen. I think that's a avenue that they might go down. Ryan Blaney mentioned something that we've talked about on this channel before, and that is that NASCAR might experiment with some of these changes at the All-Star race at North Wilkesboro. Obviously, NASCAR experimented with intermediate package changes at the All-Star race in years past. Now that the All-Star race is on a short track, maybe they look at experimenting on a short track with it. But either way, you're not getting more horsepower, which is really unfortunate. The more horsepower group, I should have worn my suits hate horsepower. And it's not that they hate horsepower. They're trying to attract a fourth manufacturer, which I completely understand. But I think all of us wish that we could just get more horsepower out of it, just to see if that would be the solution, right? Just to see, is that going to make things better? I think it would, especially with a softer tire. Really just blow the doors off of these things here. All right, moving on to the other hot topic of the day. That would be everybody's favorite topic, charter negotiations. Because who doesn't love hearing about the business side of the sport? Yeah, they're still not close. Well, Steve O'Donnell, through Adam Stern, tweeted out from the Sports Business Journal, tweeted out on Wednesday afternoon that Steve O'Donnell says that they're close to a charter agreement with the teams. Literally 1 hour later, Adam Stern tweeted again, said he talked to three teams and said, yeah, we're not close. We don't know what Steve's talking about. Pull the old Lee Corso. Not so fast, my friend, because they apparently aren't very close on negotiations. Obviously, right now, we all know what the holdup is. There's two main factors to the holdup. One comes down to TV revenue, the split. The other one comes down to the charters. TV revenue-wise, teams want more money from the TV revenue. The current revenue breakdown is 25% of the teams, 65% to the tracks, and 10% to NASCAR. Teams want 50%. NASCAR has apparently offered them up to 42%, which the team said, no, that's not going to work. So there has at least been some sort of compromise on the NASCAR side to the tune of an additional 17%. What happens there? That remains to be seen. That is a major sticking point. Teams, of course, want more money because they would like to not have to rely on the sponsorship model as much to fund these race teams. And I don't think that's a crazy concept. Think about back in like the 90s or the early 2000s where you could just hire a driver and then worry about going out and getting a sponsor. Now you're hiring drivers because they bring sponsors. They have sponsor relations or the sponsor's like, hey, we want that guy in this car. Teams want to have a little bit of that power back in their hands. And they would like to turn a profit or at least try to break even. If Hendrick Motorsports isn't making a profit, then nobody's making a profit at this point other than maybe your smaller teams who aren't investing and pocketing that money. Different topic. On the other side, when we get to the charters, teams want charters to be permanent. NASCAR, through what we've heard, would rather have charters move on a TV deal by TV deal basis, essentially. So they would like to start in 2025, extend the charter agreement for the next 7 years, which is the length of the next TV contract. And then after that, negotiate again. Why? Because it gives them some sort of power. It allows them to hold that charter negotiation above the team's heads. It's classic negotiation tactics, and there's nothing wrong with that. Both sides are trying to get the best value that they think that they should get for their side. I have no problem with that. Teams, meanwhile, want charters to be permanent because it provides a lot of equity to them, and they've all invested a lot of money in this, and they don't want to see that go away. Like, multiple team owners have mentioned that, like, this is an equity asset that they'll be able to pass down to other generations, to their families, things like that. Think about it the same way that an NFL franchise works. Imagine if Jerry Jones owns the Cowboys and they're like, oh yeah, well, you are the owner of the Cowboys, but we'll look at that every 7 years and you could possibly lose that. And that $1 billion could just get yanked out from underneath you. That's the problem here. And unfortunately, NASCAR's franchising model doesn't resemble what an actual franchise model should look like that we see amongst the other professional sports, baseball, football, basketball, even hockey. Their model is different. Maybe we'll talk about that in a video. If people want to like kind of hear the breakdown, let me know in the comments and I'll work on that eventually. So right now, teams want those charters to be made permanent. It makes a lot of sense. Will it get done? I don't know, right? Jim France, the CEO of NASCAR, does not love the idea of charters. And why would he? Because it takes some of the power away from NASCAR here. So I understand both sides of this argument, but teams aren't going to relent on that, and they're at a stalemate now. So a lot of people are wondering, like, well, what happens if they don't come to an agreement? Is there going to be a protest? Are they going to sit out a race? Are they going to do something? That remains to be seen. Adam Stern said he had heard rumblings about that a few months ago. We haven't seen it happen yet. I doubt it happens because that would be a huge black eye for the sport, huge black eye for the teams as well, especially at a time where like fan sentiment is on the rise. You don't want to kill that momentum that you currently have. On the other hand, if they make it all the way until the December 31st deadline, which is, of course, the end of the year, if the clock hits 12:01 into January 1 and they don't have an agreement, NASCAR rescinds all of those charters. So all those charters that people have, they're worth nothing now. Could this lead to a split IndyCar style, IndyCar car, Champ Car type of situation? No, I don't think it will ever get to that point. This deal will get done. I think it's just going to leave a lot of people with hurt feelings, and it's going to take a lot of time for those to maybe mend. But for now, The two sides apparently don't remain close. So, let me know in the comments what you think about both of these issues. The tires with short track and the commitment to not increasing horsepower, as well as the standoff between NASCAR and the teams. Like and subscribe to the channel. Follow me on TikTok at BreakHard, Instagram and Twitter at BreakHardBlog.